There was a Nazi train that was seized in 1945 that was filled with paintings, artworks, gold, and jewels.
Although large quantities of Nazi loot was found, there's so much more that is missing, still to be returned to its rightful owners. After the war, there are reports in Poland of a Nazi train laden with gold, spotted by locals shortly before the Allied invasion. The train is estimated to contain 300 tons of missing treasure worth around $10 billion.
This would represent probably the most significant stockpile of stolen wealth in the world.
The key to the location of the train, Dembinski believes, is in the landscape. Occupied Europe is devastated towards the end of the war by Allied bombers and the retreating Germans. And post-war reconstruction further alters the landscape. Between the wartime Allied and German maps and modern satellite images, there are many differences. Certain features like railway lines, bridges, and tunnel entrances are present in the maps, but are gone from the satellite images.
There are clues in the satellite images, but you really have to know what you're looking for.
But the satellite images are throwing up too many potential hiding places. Dembinski must narrow down the search.
This is a massive region. It's crisscrossed with railway lines.
According to reports in Poland, towards the end of the war, a heavily guarded Nazi train was seen at a railway junction in Valberje, and that's where Dembinski is headed. He has a lead, a local man. Tadusz Slawakowski is a retired coal miner who was just a boy when the Nazis occupied Poland. According to Slawakowski, the train spotted here is rumored to be the private train of Heinrich Himmler. Himmler's heavily armored private train was an unbreakable behemoth, over 500 feet long, with two cargo carriages fitted with anti-aircraft guns. If Slawakowski is correct, then Himmler's train was on its way to the city of Rocklaw, formerly Breslau, a small but well-guarded Nazi outpost.
By the end of the war, the seemingly insignificant city is being defended very, very heavily, at the cost of defense of, say, Berlin.
It is thought that the Germans used Rocklaw to store stolen loot and turn the city into Fort Knox. But in 1945, it becomes clear the city will fall to Stalin's Russian troops. But before that, it is said that a train loaded with valuables leaves the city.
This train is loaded and headed west to escape the advancing Red Army.
But where might you hide a 5,000-ton train loaded with gold? Slawakowski claims to have heard an account from an eyewitness.
Tadeusz says that he met a witness, someone who, towards the end of the war, claims that they stood up onto the tender of a steam locomotive and they could see two wagons in tracks leading off into a tunnel.
Towards the end of the war, the Nazis are known to have buried valuables in caves and then blown up the entrances. Did they do the same to the tunnel?
Collapse the ends of the tunnels and you have a perfect tomb, if you will, to hide a whole bunch of loot.
But the Nazis didn't have time to dig new tunnels as the Soviet army approached. They must have used an existing tunnel. As it happens, the Nazis were engaged in digging out a large tunnel complex in the nearby Owl Mountains.
There is this gigantic complex built underground called Project Riza, and the railway line passes fairly close.
The long-abandoned Nazi tunnels in this area stretch for miles. Precisely why they were built is not known.
This project is surrounded in mystery because there's no documentation to suggest why the Nazis would dig all these tunnels.
Tunnels are the obvious place to hide trains.
So I want to travel out to the Riza project complex and have a look.
Only part of this immense underground complex has been excavated. There are miles of tunnels still to be discovered and properly explored. Many tunnels have collapsed or been blocked off. Above the complex, satellite images show a pine-covered hillside and a nearby railway line. Could they be connected? Rieser is the German word for giant. Extending as far as 6 square miles, the abandoned complex is one of the largest subterranean structures on the planet.
The scale of these construction projects is absolutely unimaginable. The Germans build miles and miles of underground complexes for hiding things.
The complex has only been partly excavated and explored. A large part of this labyrinth was sealed off after the Nazis abandoned it in 1945. It took 23,000 slave laborers dragged from Nazi concentration camps to dig this extraordinary tunnel complex. They were almost all worked to death from exhaustion and starvation.
Conditions down here must have been utterly awful.
It is known that the Nazis used tunnels to house secret armament projects, like the construction of the V-2. But what these tunnels were for remains a mystery.
We can see boreholes where the dynamite would have been placed.
Dembinski is looking for clues. For tunnels tall enough to accommodate a train, for signs of train tracks, for indications that tunnel entrances have been blocked or sealed.
Wow, that is something.
Nearly a mile into the hillside, and Dembinski encounters a problem.
Wow. Woo.
The tunnels are flooded. To go any further, Dembinski must continue by boat.
That is amazing. Why on earth were the Germans building this? What was this all about?
The tunnels here are big enough to hide a train. But it's hard to tell if there are remnants of railway tracks beneath the water. Dembinski needs to review the satellite images.
There must be a spur connecting the railway to this. And the question is where?
Dembinski will map the complex as best he can, looking for a section of tunnel which might lead from the nearest railway outside.
This is an extremely exciting moment, comparing these two images.
Dembinski is comparing wartime maps of the Owl Mountain foothills with modern satellite images.
Now, I'm looking for houses that have been knocked down during the war. And I'm also looking to see whether there's any evidence of subsiding land over a possible tunnel.
A train this valuable would have been very heavily guarded and protected. Wherever it ended up, there should be signs of other activity around.
I'm looking for evidence of military activity.
Dembinski makes a short list of potential sites.
This location is stronger than all the rest because it is the closest to the Riza complex. The tunnel is the right length. If I were a German general, I would hide the train here.
Dembinski sets out to search the area. He believes the interior layout of the Riza complex suggests there may be blocked off tunnels which extend beneath these hills.
This has the look and feel of a military installation. This is right by the tunnel, so this could be related to the railway line.
There is a modern train line built on the ground of an older train line, and a railway tunnel still in use. But Dembinski won't be exploring it today.
The tutaj nie wolno stać, tak?
I've just been told that I can't go down there because it's an active railway, which is fair enough, but it does mean that I won't be able to investigate inside the tunnel.
There is no guarantee that the vast quantities of missing gold plundered by the Nazis ended up here. But if it did, and if local reports are correct, Dembinski is convinced that an armored train built for Heinrich Himmler, containing around $10 billion of stolen gold, may well be sitting right at his feet. And he won't stop looking until he's found it.